This tutorial will explain the basic characteristics of the SageJournal Online database and how to conduct an advanced search. To access the database, you must first go to Wiggins Memorial Library homepage, which is www.lib.campbell.edu. Once you're at the homepage, you may click on the last tab titled Databases. Once you've clicked the Databases tab, you'll see an alphabet listing and you'll want to click on the letter S. SageJournals Online will be the second listing. Click into the database. The homepage for SageJournals provides links to and information about journal content and features. The header along the top of the page lists the following: Home, Search, Browse, My Tools, Information and Services. If you are recognized as an authorized user of an institutional subscription, the name of the institution will appear at the top of the page, and in this case it is Campbell University. If you have signed in with your individual username and password, your name and links to manage your account will appear at the top of the page instead. If you would like to create an account within SageJournals, all you have to do is come over to Sign In and click in. You'll scroll down to Sign Up, Not Yet Registered, and click into the Click Here link. From this page, you will start the process to register for your own account. The benefits of your own account are listed under My Tools. You'll have access to email alerts, you'll be able to mark your citations, save your searches, save your favorite journals, and manage your account. Let's return to the home page to conduct an advanced search. You can click that option within the middle column. Click into Advanced Search. I'm going to use the key terms Child Welfare and Funding. I have four areas within I can search: SageJournals available to me, all Sage content, select from a list of disciplines, or select from a complete list of journals. Notice that you can only select from one of the four. My favorite journals is not an option right at this time because I have not signed in to my account. I'm going to choose the SageJournals available to me, so that way I'm only getting results from journals that Campbell has access to. I'm going to adjust my date range to a more recent date. And I can also monitor how many results I want per page and how I want the results sorted. And I want my results sorted by date. And now I can click search. I have 10 listings on the first page, but I have 1,578 in all. I can further condense my list by having the earliest first, or the most recent result first, or the most relevant. Now I'm going to leave mine on most recent. At this time, they're in standard format citations, but I can change it to condensed. And then I will click go. So it's even shorter information on the listing page. As I'm reading the title, I can decide if Once I've read the title, if I think I'm interested in that article, to further make a decision, I can click into the abstract. And that is where I'll be given the summary of the article and the key terms for that article. If I'm interested in the full text, I can go back and click into the full text. The sidebar gives me several options. I can email the article, I can download it to my citation manager as well. I can also click the document with the arrow at the top of the header, download the article. I'm going to open it in Adobe Reader. And here's the article. I now have the option of saving that article to my computer or flash drive. Just going to close the article. Going to go back to my results listing and go back to the home page. Hopefully, this tutorial has explained the basic characteristics of the Sage Journal Online Database. Please contact me if you have any questions. My name is Lakeisha Darden, and I can be emailed at Darden, DARDENL, @campbell.edu. Best wishes on your assignment.